In this video, I'll be telling you how exactly you can create thumbnails using PowerPoint presentation which are going to really stand out, which can help you to get great views for your videos as well. A complete tutorial in a very simple step so that you can create thumbnails which are going to stand out. Welcome to Sriram Benur channel. Let's get started. So I'm using PowerPoint version 2020. So the moment you open PowerPoint presentation, this is how it looks. Okay, with a blank slide. Now I really don't need any texts over here. Let me just remove it for now. So it's completely blank. Now I don't want this to be white. In fact, like I would prefer something which is a darker background so that the text are going to be highlighted well. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to right click on it, click on format background, and I'm going to select as black. Okay, so this is how it looks right now. Now I don't want to have the plain black background as well, so let me just add a small image on top of it. So say for example I want to add this particular image. Now you could see it is not completely fitting the screen. So what we could do, it's very easy to drag it and make it as completely full. Okay, now once this is done, now this is highlighting a lot, so I don't want something like this. So right click on this, format picture. When you come to this picture section, it says transparency. Let me just reduce the transparency. Okay, you could see it right now. So it's completely reduced and it is looking more like a black section right now. Correct. Now on top of this, the text is going to be highlighted as well. Now to write the text, so let's go to home. Okay, insert, select the text box. Now say for example I want to create this thumbnail which says monetization approved in 2 days. Okay, so let me just write that monetization. Okay, let me select the font as white, monetization. Okay, and I'm going to select as approved in 2 days. Okay, so you can just click here and select the size that you prefer. Say for example I'm going to keep it as 60. I'm going to make it as bold. So we can select the font what we want. So I'm going to select as Franklin, so this one. Now this is how it looks, not something great. So we are going to make it something which is going to stand out as well. Okay, so what we'll do, this is something that is more important for us. Okay, so I'm going to make it as the yellow background and I'm going to make the text as black. I could say monetization approved in 2 days. Now this is slightly looking better than the previous one. Now let's also make this monetization slightly bigger. Let me give 70, or rather 80. Okay, 82, another couple of, okay. So now, okay, so monetization is getting highlighted, approved in 2 days is getting highlighted. Now to make it more appealing, okay, let's add some images here. So I have taken this image that had come to the email. Let me just drag and drop this. But this is taking the full screen, but we don't want something like this. We can certainly crop this. Let me just click on this. See, once you double click on this, you have an option here to crop. Okay, so you can just click on crop. Let me just crop this. Okay, once done, just click on crop. Now this section is crop. Now just plain something like this is not looking good. So again, just double click on it. Now you see this, right? There are multiple different frames that has been shown there. Now select the one that would look good. Let's say this one, not looking so great. Let's select this one. Yeah, I think this is something that is looking good. Okay, so let me select this. Let me move it slightly here. Okay, now this is looking good. Now, again, probably an image of ours would be a lot more better on this. So I have an image. Okay, so I have a transparent image. If you don't have a transparent image, what you could do is go to Google or search as remove background. Okay, just type as remove background. When you go there, okay, I have already added an image here. So let me just select a new file and show you. Okay, say for example, I'm selecting this file. I'm just dragging and dropping. The moment you do that, it is going to remove the background. Now you see, the background has been removed. You can just download this. Once you download, it becomes a transparent image. Okay, so that's what I have done here. I have a transparent image and I have another transparent image as well. So let me just add this to my thumbnail. So this is something that is not looking great because the height should be still more. What we'll do, we'll go with this one. Okay. Okay. So let me just keep it here. Okay. Now I could see this is looking better. Now let me also tell you one thing before this. If I delete this, right, you also have an option here where by default the PowerPoint also gives you a lot of design ideas. If there is something that connects to you, you can certainly choose that as well. Say for example, maybe something like this, or there it would be suggesting a lot of it. Okay, so if it is very simple one, there would be a lot of ideas that would be suggested which can be taken as a reference here. So I'll show you with a different one so that you get more idea. Now let me just come back and add this particular image here. Okay, so let me make it something like this, where I'm pointing exactly to 2 days. Okay, now this is something, this is looking good. Now still it looks like, okay, there is something missing. So what we will do right now, say for example, let me also add one more one shape here. Okay, I want to add a rectangle where I'm going to mention as 2022 video. Okay, the moment you select it, you draw that shape, you find something like this. Okay, let me select this and write here as, sorry, write here as 2022, and let me select the font size as 60, make it bold. Okay, but this is not going to look good, I think. So let me make it as yellow. Okay, and rotate it. When you rotate it, you can just come and keep it like this. Okay, now say for example, if I do something like this, you could see how exactly the thumbnail is going to look. Now this is not looking something appealing here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to change the background of this. Right click, format shape. So instead of black, let's give it as yellow and the text color as black. Okay, now it would have a different look. Okay, so this is how it looks right now. Now let me just close this. Now say for example, you also want to add maybe arrows or something like that, you can certainly do it. Just go to insert, you have icons, just click on that. Let me select as, say for example, I want to add a arrow. I'm just going to search that. And you have a lot of icons that are available, and it's free to use as well. So you don't have to worry about it. Okay, so as long as you are using a paid version of PowerPoint presentation, it's completely cool for you to use this. Now I want to add an arrow. Say for example, I'm going to pick this up. I'm going to click on insert. When I do that, you can see that it is coming over here right now. Okay, so I want to put it here. Let me just change, double click, right click on it, format graph, change the color to black, sorry, yellow. Okay, and solid fill, Okay, if you want to make it bigger, you can make it bigger. Slightly, if you want to rotate, you can rotate it. Now, you could see it's looking a lot more better compared to the previous one right now, right? So, now once you have created this, now say for example, okay, you also want to crop the image to a particular shape or something, you can do that. Say for example, if I just double click on this, if you want to make it as a round image, okay, you can just click on this. It is going to bring a background as round, or you can make it like this. If you don't want something like this, if you want your picture itself to be round, go to this crop section, okay? Click on crop a shape, and say for example, I'm going to select as circle, okay? Now if you see, it has cropped it here, so it has made it as a circle, okay? Now I really don't want circle, so I'm just going to leave it like that. You could see, now our thumbnail is completely ready. Now once it is ready, the beauty is you can easily save it with a very decent file size with a great clarity as well, right? So the thumbnail should be less than 2 MB. Now whenever we create using some other software, it might go beyond 2 MB as well. Now all you need to do is just click on file, okay, save as. So I just given as the name as monetization thumbnail, okay? So monetization thumbnail, so that I can remember it. Instead of PPT, select as JPEG. Okay, once done, click on save. It asks, all slides are just this one. If you have multiple slides, if you want to save all of them, you can just click on all slides. Now in my case, I want to save only that particular slide as an image. Okay, now that's where I'm going to select as just this one. Once done, you have the thumbnail with great clarity that is available here. You see this, right? Complete clarity, okay? So monetization approved in 2 days. This is how it is looking. Now say for example, if you also want to customize with more color something, you can certainly do it. And see the file size of it. The file size is just 157 KB with great clarity. The dimension is 1280x720, which is recommended for having as a YouTube thumbnail, correct? Now, if you want to slightly tweak the color of this, you can certainly do it. Say, for example, I want to change the color of this. Click on the, either you can select the color, or say, for example, I'm going to click on the eyedropper. Okay, again, I'm going to show you. I'm going to click on the eyedropper. Now, say, for example, I want to match this with my shirt color, okay? So let me just select again, eyedropper, I want this blue, right? I could see, you got this blue. Again, all you have to do is, just go to file, save as, instead of PPT, click on JPEG format, save. It asks, all slides are just this one. Now we have created two versions of it, okay? Now you could see which is going to look better. Is this looking better or is this looking better? Whichever you feel is going to drag more attention, certainly you can use that as a thumbnail. So you could see this thumbnail right now. Okay, so that's how you can create thumbnail which is going to stand out. Now let me also show you how exactly you can use the inbuilt auto-generated designs as well. Okay, let me show you that right now. Now to give you an example, I have just created another thumbnail. So say for example, can we do this better? Can PowerPoint presentation suggest a better idea? Okay, so just go to design ideas and click on that. It is going to generate a lot of design ideas which you can consider as well. Okay, say for example, I feel maybe this could be a better one as well. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to make a copy of this, paste it here, okay, and I'll go to design idea, and what I'll do, I'll update the design of this as suggested by the PowerPoint, okay, I'm going to change to this, okay. Now this is how it is looking, however the text is looking too small, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to delete this, and I'm going to add the text from this. Copy, paste. Okay, keep source formatting. Okay, now go to the second one. The same way, click on this, right click, copy, and I'm going to keep source format. Okay, now you could see, I think probably this is standing out much better than this. Okay, so that's how even auto generated designs can be something that could be really standing out as well. Okay, so that's how you create thumbnails which are going to stand out in very simple step using PowerPoint presentation. Now, if you don't have PowerPoint presentation in your PC, and if you want to buy that, certainly you can buy it from Amazon. Okay, so it might cost you around 4,900 with 6 people who can access that. Okay, so it has the activation key. Now, if you want to buy that, you can certainly buy it. I have just given the link in the below description. If you already have it, you know how to create a thumbnail which is going to stand out, which is going to help you to get great views as well. If you have any questions related to this, just comment below. I'll be more than happy to answer. And if there is any specific video that you are looking from me, just comment below. I'm going to create that video. Thanks for watching. If you're not already subscribed to the channel, please do subscribe and click on that bell notification and select all notifications so that you don't miss any videos from this channel. Always straight to point so that it's going to help you grow in this journey. Thank you very much. See you in the next video. Till then, take good care.